I just feel it's very tiring to get upset, you know.
Hi, Vidya. So cute.
Say hello, hello.
So cute. Hi, Yuti.
Cool thing is stuck with me. People that say, is classic. Oh, it was the first web series of India.
India, yeah. I'm listening to season one, and I'm doing running around the house, doing several things. And beach pe jagah jagah se mere hatne ki awaaz aati. Sumit Vyas or Nidhi Singh or Mickey Bhaiya or Tanya are back with season two of Permanent Roommates on Audible. Aur dono aaj mere saath hain har zindagi par. I'm so excited. Thank you so much, Sumit and Nidhi, for speaking to us.
Thank you for having us.
ओके सो मिकी भैया और तानिया की यूनिवर्स का उनकी जिंदगी का कौन से मोड पर इस बार आप हमको लेके जा रहे हैं विद सीजन टू ऑफ द ऑडियो शो.
तानिया आप बताएं.
ये है हमारे सीजन वन एंड सीजन टू के बीच में जो हुआ है, ये उसकी छोटी मोटी नोक झोंक. और उसमें हम पास्ट में भी जाते हैं, हम आगे की बातें भी करते हैं. तो बहुत सारी बातें हैं जो people would love to catch up on. I'm pretty sure. हम लोग को पढ़ने में भी बहुत मजा आया. We were like very excited that we are recording these. And this happens between season one and season two. So we already have a season 1.0 of Audible. Yeah. And this is another season after that.
Oh, but so, it's the same phase of life, like between the two video series. Okay. Yes, so this is an incredible integration. मतलब मार्केटिंग या जो भी आप बोलो उसकी दाद देनी पड़ेगी.
नो इट्स ब्रिलियंट. यस
क्रॉस प्लेटफॉर्म. सो एनीबॉडी विल फर्स्ट हैव टू गो वॉच सीजन वन ऑन वीडियो, देन दे कम टू ऑडिबल, हियर द टू सीजंस, एंड देन गो बैक टू वीडियो. इसमें किसका दिमाग, सुमित वाज इट यू?
नहीं, आई विश आई वाज दैट स्मार्ट, बट आई थिंक इट वाज ऑडिबल्स आइडिया एंड इट वाज अरुणा Kumar, TVF.
Yeah, and TVF has always been the trailblazers at doing everything new and for the first time and taking the plunge, and they clearly have done this with this one. And I think we are just smart enough to blindly follow them.
Yeah, उनको आता है, उनको करने.
We don't question what they want to do. We just do it.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Permanent Roommates, the first season, I think was the first. मतलब वेब सीरीज सो टू स्पीक, उससे पहले आई डोंट थिंक देयर वाज एनीथिंग हैपनिंग हियर.
इट वाज द वेब फर्स्ट वेब सीरीज ऑफ इंडिया.
या सो एंड इट बिकेम अ ह्यूज सक्सेस. आई मीन द अर्नेस्टनेस एंड जस्ट द सिंपलिसिटी, यू नो द डायलॉग्स, द रिलेटेबिलिटी. हाउ डिड लाइफ चेंज फॉर यू आफ्टर द सक्सेस? सो मीन यू फर्स्ट एंड देन लास्ट. नदी कुछ जिंदगी बदल गई टाइप्स हुआ है?
मतलब अच्छा, अच्छी चीजें हुई, क्योंकि उससे पहले भी मैं एक्टिंग कर रहा था जगह जगह पे, पर ज्यादा लोगों को पता नहीं था कि मैं एक्टर हूँ. तो वो डेफिनेटली चेंज हो गया. पीपल डेफिनेटली न्यू हु आई वाज. एंड व्हाट हैपेंस इज वन समथिंग यू डू वर्क्स एंड इट कनेक्ट्स विद अ लार्जर ऑडियंस, देन दे एक्सेप्ट यू, देन दे एक्सेप्ट योर एक्सपेरिमेंट्स एज एन आर्टिस्ट, यू नो. एंड दैट रियली केम थ्रू फॉर मी. It was definitely a breakthrough moment in my career. I had never received this amount of love and affection from random people, and even from people who were in my life. Suddenly I felt like they loved me a little more than before. I had friends who I never knew existed.
Success does that. Maybe, how about you?
Well, for me, the how it is different is that I had kind of just started working as an actor. Before that, I used to be in advertising, and then I was an assistant director for the longest time. So I mulled around with the idea of acting for a while, but I was not from Bombay, and you know, I always thought, you know, taking such a big risk and such a big plunge, because I'd seen what really happens behind the camera, and it really, really does intimidate you and really scares you, you know. So I don't think I thought that I had it in me to really like make a mark as an actor. So I was very, very skeptical of it, and I started doing a couple of plays here and there, and then that led me to a few sketches, and then that led me to TVF taking my audition for Permanent, and then I actually got it, because I hate the process of auditioning. And I always feel like this is never going to go well. I'm going to go there. I'm going to do my thing, but I don't know. It's never going to go well. And it did. I mean, touch wood. I don't know, whatever stars were in my favor at that moment. Yeah. That it worked out for me. So I think what ended up happening was that people then knew that I exist.
But did you ever imagine like a digital show at that point in time? You know, would it, have that sort of a reach and itna bada, it will become a property in itself? Any idea when you started off?
No, I don't think you can plan something that of this magnitude for sure. You sort of have an idea when you're doing something that this is nice. I mean, people are definitely, if anybody watches it, they're going to like it. But how much and how big a success it would be is hard to assess, I would say.
And I don't really think you can, you can really put a marker on anything creative like that.
I completely agree, Nidhi and Sumit. I think ki agar earnestness and sincerity kaam mein hai, toh wo touch karta hai. I mean, it appeals to audiences immediately. And whether it is small budget, big budget, if it's a good story, the work is done well in all earnestness, it touches and it works. You cannot quantify. Lekin it will leave an impact.
It will find its audience.
Absolutely, absolutely. And it did. I mean, lucky for us, it did. Sumit, tell me, how was the reception? Ye first, aapka jo Audible ka show aaya tha. It was launched in the middle of a pandemic where lots of couples were locked in. So they were trying to figure out ki kaise, ye harmoniously a time niklega. What was the sort of reaction to the first audio show?
It was quite incredible. I mean, the fact that we did a second season and we might do more seasons of it on Audible. It says that, it did quite well. And also for us, it so happened that the lockdown happened around the same time that Audible was releasing it. So that actually worked for us. People received it very well. And lately, I think the awareness of audio content has increased a lot. It is the next big thing. So be it podcasts, be it audio books, be it audio plays or whatever, or series on audio, people are really catching up to it because they realize that they can multitask while listening to a story, and I think going forward, people always want to multitask and not do one thing at a time. I am a very different kind of an audio consumer. When I'm listening to a podcast or anything, I'm actually not doing much. I'm sitting in a place and I'm listening to them. But I know a lot of people who are like listening to a book while they're doing other things. They're cooking, they're doing their household chores and they're listening to a book. I find it very difficult. I don't think I'm that bright. So I have to like sit down in one place.
Just means you're attentive.
Lekin matlab main kaise consume kar rahi hu aapka show. I'm listening to season 1 and I'm doing running around the house, doing several things, and beech mein jagah jagah se mere hasne ki awaaz aati because as a joke and everybody's like startled, ye kya hua? But it's really snackable, it's fun, it's very easy, it's totally worth binge listening to.
I think while even recording our shows, the amount we have laughed, the amount we have broken into absolute fits of laughter, because unreal.
The lines are amazing. This hame partners hi nahi, hame partners hona chahiye. Oh my god. And the earnestness, Sumit, aap itne earnestly Mickey ko portray karte hain. It's incredible. But tell me, Sumit, is there a Mikesh catchphrase or a line that aapke piche matlab pad gaya, it's stuck on you? For good or for bad, something that people either request you to say, or this, what is it?
Cool thing is stuck with me. And this was an improvisation. It wasn't there in the script, I just found it, back when we were recording, I just found it very odd. People use cool as an adjective at weird places, you want this? Yeah, cool. I was like, why would you say cool? So I used it as a joke, and then it worked. So then they were like, okay, maybe we should use it more often. And now the other thing is Baba. Everybody started calling me Baba, and my cousins are also calling me Baba. And
you also call many people Baba.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then I
also got stuck in it. Why don't we speak about that? He's also very quietly promoting it, huh? He calls his entire family.
And now everybody's going to call you.
It's a habit, and it's very annoying. I find it very odd because I keep calling people Baba because it's just a very safe way to address anyone. Nobody will get offended by it.
Correct. You have personal life experience of a permanent roommate. Now you have baby roommate also.
Is Ved there?
He's here. He gets very insecure when I'm on the phone. He's How is daddy not giving me attention?
Hi, baby.
Say hello.
So cute.
Hi, Yoti. Oh, he's so adorable.
It's like a little Sumit.
Yes. It's true.
So cute.
I saw a video of you being interrogated. You faced the heat on losing a charger, man. And you kept smiling. You came out of it unscathed. What is the Raz?
I just feel it's very tiring to get upset. You know? I find it very, very tiring.
I'm lazy. I'm not going to fight.
Get upset and, you know, go through the whole grind, then it's got to be worth it, you know? Like, so I'd rather like save it for like that one time when I'm really going to lose it. And then it should have an impact. If I keep doing it all the time, then it'll never have an impact. So me getting upset, then everybody gets a little thrown out. Why is he upset? Can he get upset? What the, you know? So it's nice. I just find it pretty tiring.
But is it, is it a good way to like smile your way through, you know, being
through life? Look at him, he's doing so.
Yeah. Baba.
Yeah, it's sometimes more pissing off for
clearly
people
is
around,
a good
you
way.
Know, when you're not fighting back.
But Nidhi, aap batao mujhe ki aapka maine, you know, I've seen the show, of course, and I've heard a little bit of, you know, the first season of The Audible. And
yeah,
aap bhi matlab monologues mein aap ye, you know, Kartik Aaryan se kam nahi ho aap, you know, your monologues when you say in this show, you say that mujhe alien se dar lagta hai ya mujhe kutte pasand hai ya billi ya main light band karke soti hu ya nahi soti hu, you know, does it come naturally ya ratta maar ke you just deliver? Or
I think so. In general I speak quite fast. In general, I do speak pretty fast. And especially if I have a lot to say Sumit knows this. I can really go on a rant. And I'll say a lot of important things, but I'll say it in a rant. So a lot of things people end up missing. And then it frustrates me. So that I do relate with Tanya a lot in that sense. And I think basically when Biso wrote the monologue, when she is so tired and then she finally says, okay, fine. If you really know me, then tell me. And then she just goes with the whole list. So he wrote it down and I'm like, really? Like, will she say it in one go? And he's like, yeah, try it. You will do it. Because he had seen me talk so many times, obviously. And so I tried it. And then they were like, fine, let's record this. And then they recorded it. And we just did it in one take. It just literally happened like that. So I believe it's kind of close to what I am in real life in that sense. I do speak very fast when I have a lot to say. So
even that reaction was an improvisation.
Yeah, the reaction was an improvisation.
That wasn't there in the script.
Yeah.
I just felt that this is how one would react to this.
Yeah, because what the hell did she just say? Because she said a lot.
Yeah. But do you guys go back and watch the show, watch your own work and, you know, laugh about it? Have you seen your show?
I mean, I've seen it once when actually Permanent Roommates is perhaps the only thing that I saw it when they launched it every time. Like I haven't seen most of the things that I do. Because I was like, kar liya phir se dobara khud ko. It doesn't excite me so much. But PR is the only show that I've seen. fully.
Yeah, and he used to see it, and then I used to ask him how it is, and that's it. I used to feed off his reaction. I used to not watch it at all.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I watched the finale of Permanent Roommate season 2, I think a year after it had released, and that too also because someone really insisted and said, okay, just at least watch it once. So it was playing and...
But why? And why weren't you watching it?
I can't watch my work back. I find it very narcissistic. I don't
know.
I just can't. I can watch it for a bit and I'll be like, okay.
But we are
unless
doing
someone
all
makes
watching.
Me watch it to like point something out that, you know, this. So then I'll sit and watch.
But Gandhi, we are doing all the watching for you on your behalf. And
please do it. Do it twice. Yeah.
And we're going to be listening to you. I'm being told I'm running out of time. And thank you so very much, Sumit and Nidhi. All the very best for
thank
the
you,
show. And hopefully we'll see you on video as well and more audio shows. And we want to keep the universe going.
Yay.
Thank you. Thank you so much. That's very sweet of you.